is a time for giving, though many Kiwi workers are going to find themselves minus that Christmas ham or supermarket voucher from the boss. That's because it's been a tough few months for many industries.
So if only a couple of weeks left at work, are there any other ways for the boss to show his or her appreciation for all your hard work?
Winding down at work and gearing up for a much-needed break. But before everyone heads off, are you expecting a wee Chrissy present from the boss?
Yep, already received one.
I'm sure we'll be looked after.
Not really. I wouldn't say I'm expecting anything, but it will definitely be a welcome addition.
I don't think we are.
I've worked really hard this year, so definitely love a bottle of bubbles.
British businessman Matt Moulding is certainly a cool boss. The billionaire gifted his staff shares, turning 74 of his employees into millionaires. So, big or small, should Kiwi employees be giving gifts this Christmas? Or after a tumultuous 2020, should employees simply lower their expectations?
Employment Relations Advisor Courtney Woods is with us now. Great to talk to you, Courtney. Now, for employers watching this, what is the merit in giving employees a Christmas gift?
Yeah, well, obviously this year's been a very tough year for employees and employers alike, so giving a Christmas gift is such a great morale booster. Receiving a gift from an employee's perspective is also just such a great way to, you know, feel recognised for hard efforts throughout the year. And from an employer's perspective, giving a gift just shows that recognition and that, you know, that thanks the employees for the efforts throughout the year.
I think you're dead right, but having said that, Courtney, do employees need to lower their expectations this year?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, it's a given that this year a lot of businesses have had to cut costs throughout the year, so they may not have the budget for elaborate gifts, Christmas parties, bonuses, as they usually would. So I think naturally employees should just expect that the Christmas workplace experience might be a little bit different this year than it has been in previous years.
What could be some budget-friendly options instead?
Yeah, there are definitely some cost-efficient ways to recognise employees. Why not, you know, get a food truck? Food trucks are such a cost-effective but fun way to just boost morale within the workplace. Also, things such as subscriptions or subsidising subscriptions, maybe let's say for a gym membership or a, you know, insurance scheme or personal development, that's a really great one. Not only does it get, you know, the engagement, but it also encourages long-term retention by, you know, giving something employees something to look forward to in the future.
And what if it's like Seven Sharp and there's no budget at all? What's something the boss can do for free?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. There are definitely ways to reward employees without spending money, whether that be considering an early finish one day or maybe a Friday afternoon off work. A really cost-effective yet simple way to recognise employees is by sending them a handwritten message from directors or senior management. That's such a simple yet effective approach for employees to feel individually recognised by management. We can also consider flexible working arrangements, whether that be allowing employees to work from home temporarily over the Christmas period, or whether it be, you know, allowing them to work from home permanently into the future as well.
Thanks, Courtney. Some lovely ideas there. Take care. We'll see you later.
Thank you so much.